Dodger from 1927 was a silent horror film directed by Alfred Hitchcock. Yeah, you can't do a silent horror film marathon without looking at some of the early works of Alfred Hitchcock. So the story is loosely based on Jack the Ripper, a serial killer in London is on the loose, called the Avenger, who goes around killing blonde-haired girls. Meanwhile, a couple, Mr. and Mrs. Bunting, take in a lodger who's played by Ivor Novello. He's a quiet but very odd young fellow. He takes a liking to their blonde-haired daughter, Daisy, who's played by June Tripp. But then the Buntings begin to suspect that he may be the Avenger, and are worried that he's after Daisy as his next victim. It's really cool and a suspenseful story, much like Alfred Hitchcock's other films. Also, the acting is actually quite good by everybody, especially Novello as the lodger. He was a box office draw in the 1920s and throughout the silent era. It's easy to see why. His performance really makes for a believable character that you can connect with and sympathize with. The rest of the cast in support of Novello, especially Mary Ault and Arthur Chesney, as his increasingly frightened landlords, Malcolm Keane, whose character is done rather dirty by the script, plays a suspicious cop who loves her. This is the first real Hitchcock movie, and the one in which he really starts to use all of his abilities. Although we can see that it's not mature yet though. It's very interesting because he makes a lot of experiments in this film, like the glass ceiling, and we can really see how hard he went at the time to really make his mark and to stand above the rest. I was really satisfied with the ending. There was a twist at the last minute that really made it suspenseful. The first 20 minutes of The Lodger are also pretty impressive, with Hitchcock slowly telling us about the killer and his particularities, until the arrival of Ivor Novello. So if you're interested in what some of Hitchcock's earlier works are, then don't pass this one up. Also, if you're a die-hard Hitchcock fan, then this'll be pretty interesting. And even if you just like silent movies in general, then give it a watch because it satisfies in both areas.